So good afternoon, everybody. We're here at the GLF in Katowice alongside COP24. We're having an exciting event with lots of speakers talking about how we can take climate action in the landscape. And I'm here with Ms. Charlotte Streck, who is the founder and director of Climate Focus. Welcome, Charlotte. It's a pleasure to have you here.
Thank you.
Can you tell us a bit more about what Climate Focus is about and what is it working on?
The Climate Focus is a specialized think tank / advisory company that works on international climate change, with a focus on a big part of our work relates to the green part of climate change, so land use, so that is forestry and agriculture, agricultural supply chains, and everything which has to do with the interface of conservation and climate change. We do a lot of strategic and advisory work at the interface between research and implementation. So we coordinate groups that produce research, and partly also we engage in research ourselves. But the main point is to translate it into messages and information that then policymakers and the private sector and NGOs, larger NGOs, can take to do advocacy work, but also on implementation. And partly we also then work with governments and NGOs on the actual implementation of these strategies on the ground.
And in which regions of the world are you focused on, or is it all across?
Well, we are generally international, but we are a small team with limitations. So we are about 30 people, and we do a lot of work in Latin America. We do a lot of work around landscape management and improvement of the efficiency and landscape use in Latin America. But I also have colleagues with strong expertise in Africa, and working on development, linking development and sustainable land use in Africa. We do occasionally work in Asia, but I wouldn't say that this is our strongest part. So more Latin America and Africa.
So being focused on Latin America, for example, what would be the greatest challenges in when we talk about climate change mitigation and adaptation and in your projects?
So Latin America is the continent that we have where we have an abundance of land. So where compared to the rest of the world, we have relatively few people on a lot of land, very different in comparison to Asia or Africa. And that means also that leads, on one hand, there is a great potential because it's a great potential for agriculture and really providing the world with food and fiber. But at the moment, this land is often very badly managed. We have a lot of degraded land, and we have, because of the inefficiency in using it, we have a lot of deforestation. Continuous agriculture pushes into the forest. We have an increase in deforestation, and again in many geographies, and lose very valuable ecosystems. And linking it to the theme of today, of the Landscape Day, we also have still problems with recognition of indigenous people's rights, and we know that indigenous peoples are very good stewards of the forest, but often this is not recognized. And we continue to have in Latin America, in Central America, but also in Colombia, in Peru, in Brazil, a lot of violence around the forest frontier.
And what is the situation on making progress on indigenous people's rights in these countries?
We have in many of these countries, we have an improvement on the legal frameworks. So the frameworks, the laws and policies that are adopted increase participatory rights, but it doesn't necessarily, implementation with all these things is a different story. So you have the parties, so you have, for example, access of information rights, but then this information is not in all local languages, it is costly to obtain, it is on platforms which are not accessible to the rural communities, so it is often a theoretical right and not a practical right. And similarly on consultations and decision making, consultations often are technical, often it is that the results of or the messages of consultations are not taken into account in the decision making that follows. And if you look also in the more vulnerable a community is, the more vulnerable a group of people is, the less they are hurt. So we have local communities that often are not hurt, indigenous peoples even less, and then you take women even less. So you see, there is an intention to improve it, and also on paper, but reality is lacking behind.
And you were just part of a conversation regarding the Indigenous Peoples Platform with a few very interesting speakers that have experience in that. So what are some of your takeaways from that conversation?
For me, the most important takeaway is that we need to find a way to empower Indigenous peoples to lead a way to lead the platform, but then also to make sure that their knowledge is properly recorded and shared with the rest of the world. And this is not something that people like, you know, we and Climate Focus can do. We can try to help to empower these groups so that trying to find finance or trying to find, give them a voice. But at the end, it is the Indigenous people's knowledge needs to be led and recorded by Indigenous people. And I think the platform is a great opportunity in this respect, and something that was missing in the process. And I also acknowledge that there the climate community is lagging behind those that work on biodiversity and in other fora. And I'm very happy to see that climate is catching up a bit.
That's great. And at the Global Landscape Forum, we want to be a platform that connects all these stakeholders, and there's a lot of discussion how there are a lot of initiatives and a lot of great ideas, but people are not communicating. As part of a think tank that advises different stakeholders, how can Climate Focus, or what do you actually do to improve this dialogue?
So we have some experience in coordinating stakeholders, because we act as a secretariat for a number of these initiatives. So I presented in the Global Landscape Forum the work that we do on the New York Declaration on Forest, which is where we have created and we coordinate the New York Declaration Assessment Partners, which are 23 and increasing number of NGO think tanks and academic institutions that generate data around forest and deforestation. And we compile this in reports once a year. So this, and where we also coordinate a dialogue platform for the Colombian Amazon, which is very local, where we coordinate local initiatives and NGOs and groups that work on projects in the Amazon in Colombia. And the experience in this is, it is something that needs a lot of dedication and a lot of time. Because again, if you want that people, that groups and people feel that they really form, that they are being heard and that they can provide input, you need to dedicate time to really bring the different opinions together and make sure that you empower each and every organization to be part of it, because then you develop the strength and then they can start contributing a lot more and with less skepticism. So at the beginning, the engagement is always, well, do these people only want to take knowledge, and then they run with it and use it for something else? And it takes a time and effort, dedicated effort, to overcome these, and then it becomes a very rewarding experience. But it needs to be acknowledged also by donors and others that this is an effort that takes a lot of time and resources. It's not an add-on to something else.
Okay. Well, thank you so much, Charlotte. It was a pleasure talking to you.